So we're on the road now. We're headed up to meet up with some friends here out near Sisters and do a little bit of camping and a little bit of exploring. It should be a really good time. I wasn't entirely sure what to expect when I got up here, as no one was really sure about snow levels, but clearly that wasn't an issue. I arrived without any setbacks and found my friends Drea and Jason of Rad Adventures Northwest, along with Chris and Jen Reel, Drea's sister Jen and her son Lionel, and her boyfriend Miles. I met most of these guys at the Primal Outdoors winter campout over New Year's Eve, and we've become great friends since then, even spending some time camping on the coast. You might remember Jason and Drea from my tsunami camping video in January. After saying hello to everyone, I quickly picked out a spot on this beautiful ridgetop to call home for the night. The ridge we camped on was stunning. Among the beautiful ponderosa pines, we enjoyed views of nearby Lake Billy Chinook, Green Ridge, Mount Hood in the distance, and even Mount Jefferson made an appearance. This is a beautiful location, and I can't wait to return soon and explore more of this area. After we got settled and got a fire going, it was time to start cooking dinner. I vowed that I would cook at least one really good meal this trip, so I was determined that this was the night. I decided to make a camping version of chicken Alfredo. Now, since this isn't a cooking show, I'll speed it up for you. First, I cut up some chicken breast and cooked it in butter and garlic. Next, I added some frozen broccoli florets for color and taste.
Broccoli chicken!
Bro, can you broccoli chicken? Broccoli chicken, say
Broccoli chicken.
Next, I added some noodles that were pre-cooked at home to save time and topped it with my favorite jar of Alfredo sauce. Yep, this was definitely a contender for my best camping meal yet. Sitting around a campfire isn't always about just relaxing. Sometimes, you have to cut loose.
Sing us a song tonight, where we're all in the mood for a melody. You've got us feeling all right.
Really being sincere, because in a 69 my humpy nose will tickle your rear.
Where's Jason at?
Just like I told another YouTuber recently, there always has to be time for shenaniganry. The next morning, we were treated to a cloudless sky and no wind. With a chill in the air, it was only 24 degrees. We all got up whenever we wanted to. We made coffee, we made breakfast, and just spent time talking and hanging out before packing up camp and heading out. Some of us had to be back at work the next day, but I would be staying out one more night. It was difficult to leave such a beautiful spot, but I knew there was much more adventure to be discovered down the road.
With a whole bunch of really cool people this weekend, and I'm very, very excited about that. So special thanks to Chris and Jen, and also Miles and Jen, and Jason and Drea from Rad Adventures Northwest. I really appreciate you guys inviting me out to hang out all the way out here in this beautiful area. I've never been here before, so it's really cool to check out. We're going to continue airing up, and then I'm going to head into town to get some fuel. And then we'll continue our adventure solo. Okay, everybody else has gone home, so now it's time to continue on the adventure by ourselves. We're going to do a little bit of solo exploration in an area that I've wanted to explore for quite some time. And I'm really excited to get the opportunity to do that. Exploring in and around the tiny community of Camp Sherman and further up the river, but the daylight was running out quickly, and I still had to find camp. I had marked out a couple of spots, but there was one in particular that I was hoping for, and I was worried that there would already be someone camped there, so the race was on. Thank you. So I found the perfect campsite today, right on the river. It's absolutely gorgeous here. And I think what we're gonna do is set up a fire, and then I think I'm gonna start getting some dinner going because I skipped lunch today.
Now that I had a nice fire going, I decided to check out the area around my campsite. The site is situated right on a bend in the river, and this area reminds me a lot of back home in Montana, and has me really missing my fly rod.
Realized what time it was, and I haven't started dinner yet. So that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna do just a steak and some asparagus with some quick potatoes. Should be fun to try to do in the dark. Thank you.
about to be a feast.
I sat by the fire and ate my delicious dinner. I enjoyed a nice cigar and bourbon by the fire, and tonight I did just relax. Going to sleep was peaceful, listening to the rush of the river just yards away.
Good morning, everyone. It's an absolutely beautiful day here at my riverside campsite. The morning is absolutely gorgeous. I've already kind of been up a little bit. I've got a fire going and I've started some coffee, so hopefully that will be helping me wake up here in just a few. But this is what our campsite looks like. Sun is just starting to peek over the trees. It's only about 7:15, but we're gonna get the day going.
I always enjoy breakfast when I'm out camping, and nothing feels more perfect than good old-fashioned bacon and eggs. As I sit and enjoy my breakfast, I can't help but reflect on the beauty that I'm surrounded by. The Matolius River flows its 28 miles from its headwaters at Matolius Springs to Lake Billy Chinook. Since it's a spring-fed river, the flow and temperature of the river are consistent year-round. It's a hot spot for fly fishermen and host to many species of fish. The surrounding area is home to a variety of wildlife and boasts many recreational opportunities like hiking and camping. It is an honor and privilege to have this public land available to enjoy, and I encourage everyone to get out and enjoy it whenever they can.
That's it. Our time at this beautiful riverside campsite is over. It's time to head back to the coast, get a few projects done around the house that I need to get done in order to close on our purchase. So we're gonna go ahead and call this a day. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow the channel. Find us on Instagram as well. Remember, always take the road less traveled.
Thank you for watching, and if you like the video, please consider giving us a like and subscribing to the channel so you can see future adventures like this one.
Jason, Andrea, and Miles, and Jen. Don't forget Frank the dog. God, these washboards are killing me. But this has been an absolutely awesome trip. Thanks for watching. I'm just kidding. I would never leave you behind. And Facebook and all the other social media sites. I suck at this.